Okay, so I made a slight error in the previous part. I forgot to add this function, category exists, and it has an ID parameter. I also forgot the ID parameter, which is null by default in the getCategories function. I had edit post as edit posts, which obviously is not what we want. And I forgot the ID parameter here. Terribly sorry. I hope you don't mind too much. Now let's go for the addCategory.php file. Here I have this basic file set up. My title can be add a category. I'm using HTML5. I hope you don't mind too much. If you're more comfortable using HTML4 or XHTML, feel free to use whatever you want. I just sort of like using the latest technologies. So let's view this in the browser, and there we have add a category, and here we have our form. Looks horrible, I know, but that's not the point of this tutorial. So let's start coding this. Here, before we start the HTML, we're going to say if is set post name. So basically, we're checking if this field was submitted. And if it was, we're going to trim any white space from the front and end of the posted value. We need to do this to make sure that there is actually input, because we're going to check if empty name, then we have an error, of course. So the reason we trim here is to make sure that if the user only inputs like a bunch of spaces, oops, that he still gets an error for not inserting a valid name. So, if empty name, so if the name does not have a value, we're going to say error equals you must submit a user, oh, username, category name. And whoops, there we go. Now, so if they did submit one, we're going to say if category exists name. Whoops. So we're going to create the category exists function, and of course that means, oops, this needs to be name. All right, so name equals, and here we're going to protect ourselves from MySQL injection by using MySQL real escape string on the name. Remember, we're getting this name from this form. So we're dealing with user input, and that means we need to secure that data. And now we're going to say query equals MySQL query select count 1. So we are checking if there already is an entry in the database with that particular name. Select count 1 from categories where name equals name. There we go. And then we're going to return MySQL results query 0, and if that's equal to 0, we're going to return false, otherwise we return true. So this line probably looks a bit cryptic, but basically what it says is if 0 rows were returned with that category name, we're going to return false and the category does not exist. Otherwise, we return true meaning the category does exist. And that's all there is to it. So here we use count, and as you see, it's just an incredibly useful MySQL function. So we do if category exists name, then we do error equals that category already exists. And of course we also need to check if the string length of the name is greater than 24. Remember that we set the maximum length to 24 characters, so we need to ensure that users cannot add more than 24 characters for a category name. And we're going to say error equals category names can only be up to 24 characters. And then, if no error was found, so we're going to say if not is set error. Remember, if none of these conditions holds true, we do not have an error variable. So if it's not set, we can simply do add category name. Now, of course, we have not created this function yet, so let's do that. Here we have add category and name. As with the category exists function, we need to make sure it's secure. So I'm just going to copy this, and then we're going to say MySQL query insert into categories, and then we set the name equal to name. This is probably the simplest function there is in the entire blog.php file. So let's see, I guess we could redirect somewhere, but I'm not going to do that just yet. Let me just show you that it does work now. Just to be sure, let's refresh. I'm going to add one called uncategorized. Okay, category exists, is not found. Let's take a look. Of course, we call it here. Let's see. Category exists. Did we do something wrong here? Ooh, my voice sounded a bit weird there. I'm just going to pause the video and check back with you when I found the error. Alright, I made a terrible mistake. Of course, we do need to include the init file. So resources slash init.php. Spell that right, init.php. And let's try that again. Yeah. Some silly things here. Anyway, uncategorized, add category, and we get another error. That's okay, that's good for debugging. So we see that this query seems to fail. So we're going to say echo MySQL error. And let's see, I hope it did not insert something. It did not, that's good. So let's refresh. No database selected. Okay, interesting. That sure is interesting. MySQL select DB DB name. Wow. This sure is interesting. Config.php blog. Well, I've reached the 10-minute mark, and Alex wants me to stay around that a bit. So I'm just going to stop this here, and we're going to figure out the problem in the next part. Oh wait, by the way, I just see it. I of course need to change that back to root, and then when I refresh this, it works perfectly fine, and we have, if it worked correctly, the uncategorized category. So I'm gonna stop it here and see you in the next part.